So, Ellie, tell me, what did you anticipate when you went to Charlottesville?
I knew that this would be a gathering of a bunch of disparate alt-right groups. The ones that build themselves, they had been infighting quite a bit, and so I thought it was significant that they would be all getting together. I was not anticipating how organized they would be. I knew they had a ring of private security, basically, made out of, I knew they had a ring of private security comprised of Afghanistan and Iraq veterans. But once we were there on the ground, they were very well organized. They had people, you know, doing crowd control, giving out tiki torches, dropping people off at the field. It's a highly organized group.
Did they trust you? You had a conversation there in which a guy was responding to your questions in a direct manner.
No, I don't think they trust me. They don't like women. They believe the media is run by Jews. But I do try to present their arguments because I think it's really important that people understand what these people believe so that there can be counter arguments against it. And I think that's why they're willing to talk to me.
And how did the events unfold in Charlottesville through your eyes as you watched it?
Well, on Friday night, we arrived at 9:30 at a field on the Virginia campus. And there were so many people there, and they were lining up in two columns. They had tiki torches, and it was this massive line that snaked all the way across the field. It was really stunning. I mean, it was maybe in absolute terms not that huge in numbers, a few hundred people, but a very significant showing. And then when the march began, it was these animalistic chants, these grunting and very explicit anti-Semitic chants. And they were so enthusiastic. They were so pumped. It was really scary.
Scary.
Scary, yes.
Because for your own safety, or scary for what might happen because of the clash of opposing ideologies or views or whatever?
Well, scary that they had so many adherents willing to show up and show their face, first of all. Also scary because many of them were armed, not at the Tiki Torch Parade, but at the next rally. And scary because they were so emotional. It was clear they might act on their violent ideology.